This is my second NBA call up. Probably one of the most playing time I've had played when I was in the NBA. I was originally supposed to get called up by them first, but Spurs beat them to it, released me, and they called me up later after that. I just, it's hard to even elaborate on this because I was almost still wondering what went wrong because I played great with this team. All I can say is they made a mistake.
Game one of the CBA semifinals between Liaoning and Qingdao. I'm John Mita Perel. It's Qingdao, the home team. Liaoning with Guo. A nice pass in the lane to Dijon Han of the Thunder Slam, Vin Parisi.
I'll tell you, when they hooked up, it was effective, but especially in the first quarter, the Eagles came out hot offensively.
Yeah, that man, number 55, Justin Dentmon, transition three-pointer, and he was hot throughout the game, and Haddadi Harris down the lane for the flush. He's another skilled offensive player.
No doubt about it. And the Eagles really got runouts in transition, really exposed the Leopards defensively with their transition. It was an up-and-down track meet for most of the first half.
This is my sixth year. And what made me go to China was they made me an offer I can't refuse. And it was just another opportunity to win. I saw a team that in desperate need to change their whole program around. And what better person to do it than me? I've done it before, why not do it again? The challenging part about going to China is, first off, the living is different. You don't live in apartments, really. Some guys get the privilege too, but that's very rare. You live in hotels. Some of them might not be five-star, three-star, whatever. And going to a new team. Going to a new team with guys you ain't never played with before. You're so used to playing with a whole bunch of Americans who can speak English. And the language barrier is very tough over there. The only thing I learned was ni hao and shishini. That's, thank you and hello. In between Zagiris and the Qingdao double star was, I think the professionalism off the court, that was a little, it was different because Zagiris, they handle everything like professional. They tend to your needs off the court. Anything you need, they're here to make you feel like home. And I think Qingdao, I think they got away from that with what I was used to. I don't know if that's how they do it, but from what I was used to, it was a little different. And the style of play, Zagiris have a lot of good players. Not saying the Qingdao don't, but Zagiris got most of the national team players on one team. And then they play hard every possession. You know what I mean? In China, sometimes you guys play hard, but then, they get down on themselves very easy. I just think that, guys in Lithuania and in China, they owe themselves to go to college. I think college makes guys more competitive. I just think the competitive nature on my team sometimes wasn't there with some of the guys, but they worked hard. I can't take nothing from them. They worked hard. We made it far. Just don't take us big three, me, Haddadi, and Mike, to do it all. They helped us out a lot. The language barrier was hard, so they didn't understand us. They thought we was coming down on them a lot, but Lithuania, every guy just, it was just different. Everybody was just wanting to win. You know what I mean? Still dreaming. They are still.
This right here was my first ever professional basketball jersey. Playing in Israel was an outstanding experience. I got to learn a lot about their culture. Got to see a lot of biblical sites. It was my first learning experience playing against older men and like more physical competition outside of college. And we didn't make the playoffs, but we definitely played a best out of three series against another team to stay in the number one division. My good experience from there is, winning the scoring title, and my bad experience in this, it was just they didn't pay me my money on time, and that kind of left a bad taste in my mouth about Israel and going back there. This is my second professional basketball jersey. My second season as a professional athlete was with the Texas Legends. I got drafted second round, their second pick in the NBA D-League draft. I felt like it was a big step because I was always, Bobby Jones told me that, I owe it to myself to try to D-League, and I want to try to D-League and see what I can do and see if I can get called up by the NBA. Because I felt like I was an NBA player after coming back from Israel, doing what I did in Israel. I got coached by a great coach, a great player, Nancy Lieberman. And I got mentored by a good player who played a lot of years in the NBA, Antonio Daniels. This jersey is when I played in Italy, probably my second overseas jersey. Went over there after the playoffs of the D-League, and we ended up winning the division and getting second in the championship game. It was a big year. I like the city, but I don't think I'd go back just because of the bad taste and I left in my mouth about the GMs and stuff going on there. My third Europe, well, my second. This is the second team I played for as far as being overseas in Europe. Zagiris went in there not knowing what to expect, but came out with my eyes open and a smile on my face. This organization was a professional organization. One of the most professional organizations I played with over in Europe. I miss it. The fans was just like the same as in college. The atmosphere was crazy. The players was unbelievable, and they did a good job of making me feel at home. And the most important part is I went over there. They let me run the point and let me lead their team until a championship in Lithuania. And we made it to the top 16 in the EuroLeague, and that was big. Being the only American, it was a big challenge. A lot of people doubted us, and a lot of people doubted me, but I prevailed and did a great job. And, made All-Star. My All-Star jersey right here. I love putting my accomplishments up. This is my first Europe All-Star game, and unfortunately, I won the MVP. This jersey right here was my second South American jersey. I really like this team. It was in Dominican Republic. Team that never made it to the championship game, and me and some other guys just pulled it through and made them go to the championship game. Unfortunately, in this season, I twisted my ankle in a championship game really bad. I tried to come back like I was Isaiah Thomas, but just couldn't lift off that right ankle, and they kept going at me, so I had to sit down for the rest of the game. This is the Austin Toros D-League Championship jersey. This is the jersey I played in when I was in the D-League, my second year in the D-League after getting traded from the Texas Legends. This organization was really professional. They treated us like we were the Spurs. And it's gonna be one of the most memorable years I'm gonna remember. My first ever professional championship. It was big. Going in there, just thinking about just getting called up and winning games was my main focus, and didn't even know that I was in the running for MVP. And once I got it, it just made that year that much better. This is my first ever NBA call-up. Man, words can't explain how excited I was and how I couldn't wait to tell my mom about what just happened. The Austin Toros helped me get an NBA call-up by the San Antonio Spurs. Man, that feeling was great, After I got called up, I was just thinking like, man, I finally fulfilled a dream. I made it to the NBA. And after that, I just wanted to stay. And unfortunately, I didn't. And but it's definitely gonna go down as one of the most memorable times ever, getting that call before walking into the game with the Austin Toros game. This is my third NBA call up, Dallas Mavericks. That's when I got retraded back to the Texas Legends. Went in there averaging 27, 28 points a game. Just went in there on a mission. You know, I think that I got overlooked, and I just wanted to prove to everybody that I was more of a player, more of a leader than everybody expected. And the Dallas Mavericks called me up more to reward me, which I'm thankful to be rewarded, but I wanted to get called up and have a chance and get a chance to play. But I appreciate everything they did, and I'm very grateful to get called up to another NBA team. This was the New Orleans Hornets. This was my first NBA training camp. It was during a lockout year, and it was tough because I went into this season just thinking that I'm gonna do what they want me to do instead of being myself and being who they saw me as, you know? And unfortunately, I got cut, but they told my agent that they didn't see Justin till the last day. And ever since then, I've been telling myself, don't be who they want you to be yourself. If they don't like you for whoever you are, then, hey, they don't like you. But that's the reason why this was in white, because it reminds me of being yourself. Because if you be yourself and you fail, at least you fail being yourself and you ain't got no excuse.
Right inside you, so I can say hello, my only one. Just like the morning sun, you keep on rising till the sky knows your name. Hello, my only one. Remember who you are. No, you're not perfect, but you're not your mistakes. Hey, 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 hey. Oh, bad, even on your worst day. Remember I'd say, hey, hey, one day you'll be the man you always knew you could be. And if you knew how proud I was, you'd never shed a tear, have a fear. No, you wouldn't do that. And no, I didn't pick the day to turn the page. I know it's not the end every time I see her face and I hear you say hello.
Your drink ready? Hold on, first off, there's too many people watching us. We gotta close the windows. I don't want this. They gonna see me. The hardest thing about being overseas is being alone for all that time. You got a lot of time on your hands. Especially if you're in a hotel, that's a box you're in. It feels like a prison that you can just go out anytime you want. So it's just, you gotta build another hobby. You'll never have another hobby. While you're over there, you're just gonna be bored. And it's gonna get to you and it's gonna lead to on the court. You're gonna wonder why, what's going on, why you ain't, you know, doing what you used to do, you know, doing the stuff you're effective with. So that is the hardest thing.